Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You're listening to Leif.
Yeah.
Elliot. Mm-hmm. And me, Rob. Hello.
And Clive, our sound engineer.
Welcome to our podcast.
Hey everybody, we're Mood Swings and we're broadcasting to you today to kick off Rag Week.
So how are we feeling after the social? St. Paddy's social last night?
Pretty good, pretty fresh, pretty hungover. Good fun though, great night.
And speaking of that, some of you will have noticed that we're around getting our boogie down with the dictaphone, getting some sound bites, and we took it to the public for some detailed reaction.
Mate, what are your general feelings about the night?
It's great.
Thanks for that, mate. That was top quality stuff.
So profound.
What about that?
Here's what some other people thought of the night.
It was really, like, really Irish.
Really Irish. It was, to be fair. I found that. Did you guys think it was pretty Irish?
Well, it wasn't Welsh. I'll give her that.
No. No, it was
for
certainly
free.
Not.
I'll give her that for free.
I really feared the Irish. Back to my roots.
You're an Irish man.
Well, fourth generation to win.
there was a pretty strong response to the Irish theme. I'm glad that it went down well. It was St. Patrick's Day, after all, so, I mean, mission accomplished on that score.
Isn't that a classic thing, that everybody just thinks that they've got a little bit of the Irish family, that Irish blood in them?
I'm 1/32nd Irish.
Thanks, Rob.
No worries. The band playing were Ladness. They played some big tunes. Bit of Red Hot Chilies, bit of Slipknot, bit of,
Yes?
A bit of Dizzy Rascal. They were joined by our friend Dave, who did the rap for Dance With Me with the band.
We met a young gentleman in the toilet who had something to say about the band.
Band a killer. I'll be 5 minutes. Probably because I'm not part of it.
Oh, chin up, mate.
Then at the end of the night, we ended up in Babs, as per.
Yeah.
And we bumped into Clement Freud, if you can believe it. Clement Freud from the BBC. And he told us this funny story.
I heard rather nice story about a man who drank a lot. His wife said, if you ever come home drunk again, I'm going to leave you. And he went out to a pub and drank a lot and threw up all over himself. And said to his friend, if I come home, my wife will leave me. His friend said, I'll tell you what, go home and tell her somebody threw up over you and put a £20 note in your inside jacket pocket and show it and said, he gave me this for the dry cleaning bill. And he comes home and his wife, and he said, no. Somebody threw up over me, gave me £20 for the cleaning bill. She said, why have you got two £20 notes in your hand? He said, oh, the other one is from the man who shat in my pants.
Chicken wrap cheesy tips, mate. Two-piece chicken cheesy tips, mate.
Brilliant story. Great bloke as well. Really lovely guy. Next up, what have we got next? Oh yeah, okay, so many of you, if not all of you, will know the wonderful Audrey, who works in the refectory. She's a lovely woman, and has been something of a mother figure to us over the years. But from now on, she will be your agony aunt.
Mm.
Yes, that's right. You can submit your troubles and problems to us. We will take it to Audrey, and she will attempt to fix it. You're listening to Ask Audrey.
Ooh, it's Audrey.
Yeah, welcome to Ask Audrey. In this episode, a student who wishes to remain anonymous has submitted a question to us this week. There's a girl that I really like, but I've never been brave enough to talk to her. Sorry.
You can't laugh.
I know, I'm sorry. I meant it, my apologies. I want to tell her how I feel, but I'm afraid she'll reject me. What should I do?
Well, let's give it a listen.
Good afternoon or good morning. That shouldn't be a problem. All you should do, be brave. It's either a hide or say, good afternoon, young lady, how you doing? Or just pass and touch her on her shoulder and say, I'm sorry. And just to break the ice, say, how are you doing? Okay?
Thank you very much, Audrey. Thank you for your time.
Sound advice. I think we can all agree that is some sound advice from Audrey there.
Okay, next up, we're going to play a game called Shakespeare or Shit. So basically, Rob is going to present two passages of text to us. One of them will be a snippet of Shakespeare's work, and the other will be from something else. Eventually, me and Leif are going to decipher which is which. So, let's play Shakespeare or shit.
Ooh, Shakespeare or shit.
To be or not to be.
Brilliant stuff.
Mm-hmm. So, Rob, what have you got for us then?
Okay, well... What? Clive? Clive? That's supposed to be the Renaissance stuff, mate. Yeah, the William Byrd stuff. Yeah. Fuck's sake, that guy, man. Anyway, here is the first passage. How oft, when thou my music placed, upon that blessed wood whose motion sounds with thy sweet fingers, when thou gently swayst the wiry concord that mine ear confounds, do I envy those jacks that nimble leap to kiss the tender inward of thy hand.
Go on.
Yeah, what's the next one? What's the...
The second passage is... Are we crazy? Living our lives through a lens, trapped in our white picket fence, like ornaments. So comfortable, we're living in a bubble. So comfortable, we cannot see the trouble. Aren't you lonely up there in Utopia? Where nothing will ever be enough. Happily numb.
I'm numb after that.
Ooh. Nice.
So, gentlemen, Shakespeare or shit?
How do we answer it?
I don't know.
That is the question.
I think get in a bin.
What do we think?
I think it's pretty safe to say that the second one was most definitely Shakespeare. I mean, that repetition of trouble, I mean, it could only be...
Bubble.
Yes, we all know that was one of his... favoured techniques.
That was one of his favourite words, everyone.
Yes, bubble and trouble, as you may well know, appear in, I think, nine or ten, is it ten of his plays?
What, bubble, trouble?
Yes. in one form or the other.
Mate.
But the words bubble and trouble are called upon most frequently by Shakespeare.
I promise you that second one is straight out of Macbeth. It was something like something
Macbeth.
something trouble.
Yeah, well,
bubble trouble.
Toil
and bubble.
Toil with a twig. Or...
Well, well, the results are in.
I never gave one, but
I'm a. Oh well, what's your opinion,
no, it's
man?
Fine. I'm going to cause an argument and go for the first one as good old Willy's.
Well, the points go to Mr. Samphire.
Mm-hmm.
The first passage was a Shakespeare. The second was taken from one of my favourite songs, Chained to the Rhythm by Katy Perry and Skip Marley. So there you go. But I really had you there with the bubbling and the trouble, didn't I?
No. God. What was going to be something like... You could have gone for William Blake or something like that, at least. You went f***ing Katy Perry.
I thought it was good. I thought I chose a really clever bit.
No.
Yeah. All right, now we're going to play a game that we like to call Is This Moob Fibbing to You?
Is this move fibbing?
Is this move fibbing?
Is this move fibbing to you?
Is this move telling a fib or the truth? Yeah.
In this game, one of us has to tell a story. The rest of us have to decide whether we think they're fibbing or they're telling the truth.
This week, Elliot's giving us the story. What have you got for us, Elliot?
I lost my virginity when I was 6.
Straight up lie.
Lie.
Yeah, it was a lie.
Is this move telling a fib or the truth?
Twas a lie!
So that was a tough loss to take, but I'll move on. It's crunch time now. Earlier we ventured to our favourite restaurant, Babylon, for our dinner. We all had margarita pizza. This is Babylon Soundbites.
Babylon Soundbites!
What I think is really nice is how herby the tomato sauce is. Do you ever think about that?
Trey herby.
Trey herby. An important thing to consider is when you're choosing the sauce that you want with it as well. Of course, we all go for a lake of garlic mayonnaise accompanying our...
I kind of wish we brought some sweet chili with it.
Not for me, personally.
Oh.
That cheese is just, like...
so stringy.
Chicken wrap cheese!
That's not what he said when he announced our pizzas. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
If you need my sauce, come to Papa.
Looking back at it, that was awful. That really did not taste good.
Chicken wrap.
What are you talking about? That shit's the best.
Sorry.
Shit, I forgot to eat my acid reflux tablet. Cheese, tomato, and bread are all really terrible for acid reflux.
Oh, no!
Where did it come from?
Rob's got mayo on his hairy arm.
Lick it off.
Oh.
Lick it from mine arm.
All in all, I think it's safe to say that that was a fabulous meal. Now it's time for a horoscope.
Horoscopes.
Oh, ghostly.
Okay, Clive, why don't you give that horoscope wheel a nice big spin?
Gemini! It's Gemini. Elliot, what have you got for Gemini this week?
Okay. The rising moon on the tipped axis of Uranus says you were once born. And at some point in the next few days or weeks, you will meet someone else who was once born.
Wow. That's good stuff. You do need to make sure you check out your horoscopes, don't you? Because... you never do know what is around the corner. Right, we're nearly done, so I just wanted to mention this week at college it's Rag Week. There's events going on all week to help raise money for charity, like a quiz that's happening tonight at Halls. So do make sure you check out a flyer or the events on Facebook so you know what's going on and get involved. Yeah, I'll just give you our thought of the day, which has been kindly provided by our sound engineer Clive. So here it is. Hug your haters and kill them with your kindness.
Fuck off, Clive.
Oh, Clive. Okay, we're going to leave you now with our tune of the day called Losing My Way by FKJ and Tom Misch. You've been marvellous. We've been Moob Swings.
through this darkness. She was heartless in every way. I'm losing my way.
Oh, hang on. This would be better if you guys, have the front side, share the front side, and then I have the back side myself.
Yeah, you'd like that, wouldn't you?